Addressing the press from his residence in Chengela this evening, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, scoffed at public criticism on the opposition's legislative agenda, saying it's far-fetched.
Of you and the leaders out there that had a different imagination of it, please speak to those who know what we meant, so that we can explain to you that you do not mislead the public as though the agenda was the final product.
The agenda highlights issues of reforming political representation and the fossils of decentralization, operationalization of the national objectives and directive principles of state policy, enforcement of service delivery, national health universal coverage, education financing and access, prioritizing games and sports, curbing wasteful expenditure, among other priorities. Mpuuga says the opposition has lived to its expectations, using the legislative agenda as the blueprint to guide its programs.
Agenda was a pathway, was a roadmap to an end. It's not an end in itself. And I have even seen, to my consternation, very serious people in this country questioning the wisdom of a legislative agenda. But I could easily understand where they're coming from. First of all, they have never had any political group articulating an agenda. They have only seen political groups agitating.
He quotes the alternative national budget, which the opposition unveiled to the public recently as a milestone achievement attributed to the legislative agenda. He believes they have been able to sharpen the quality of debate by training and equipping legislators with skills to deliberate on key issues.
Look at our subsequent documents. They actually speak to that. When we read alternative budget priorities, we are speaking about constitutional reforms, changing the structure of parliament, changing the nature of our constitution, rejigging and rethinking and remodeling local governance, or rather devolution of powers, having witnessed the death of local governments and decentralization. That's what we are doing.
Mpuuga lashed out at elites who criticize undertakings of opposition as enemies of the opposition liberation struggle. He blamed them for misleading the public that change can come without strategic organization.
It is an elitist idea that people do not know what you are saying. It's the elite. And it's because the elite are dispirited and the elite have since stopped thinking. They believe that somebody is going to wake up and donate to them a government, and they partake of it and be very happy. I want to educate and advise my friends, the elite, that no one is going to wake up and donate to us power. Power is not a donation, it's not a grant, because they want it the easy way. And wanting things the easy way is the biggest danger of the opposition.
Meanwhile, the leader opposition has hailed the prosecution of the embattled Minister of Karamoja Affairs as a big step to the right direction of fighting corruption in the country.
I'm happy with the fact that the DPP has taken the next big step of beginning prosecutions. And my contemplation is that these investigations are quite easy to make, because the trail of the theft is in the public domain. I suppose that the DPP in the coming days should be able to align more people in court.
He, however, says more needs to be done to ensure that all ministers implicated in the scandal face the wrath of the law. Report compiled by Fred Kanjui for the news.